Hello, 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 ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna make myself bigger because I'm the only one here right now. What up? What up? What's good? How's it going? Love you guys. It is Geek Swag. We are back, ladies and gentlemen. We are here. We are ready to do our thing. At least I am. I don't know about everybody else. I'm gonna get this glare out of y'all's way real quick. Hold up. Hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up. Hold up. Let me get this light where I want it, because we got a lot of glare going on in the background. Apologize. We gotta help a little bit. Whew. This is like big time glare. Turn this so we don't have so much. It's my Star Wars poster. Can't have glare on that. Not poster, but you know what I mean. My Star Wars picture can't have glare all over that. Oh, goodness. So, ladies and gentlemen, one of the big things I wanted to show you guys is like right here. Boika shots. This is the big one. This is what I was hoping for Christmas, and finally I got it. Well, along with my lovely Joker poster. Well, not poster. Autographed and everything. Neil, I can't remember his name. My sister bought it for me, so I will have to look that up so you guys know who the artist is. Some of you guys that are big Joker fans probably already know, or big Batman fans probably already know. But hold on a second. Let me see if I can get Dirty Hell Motto on the scene real quick. Oop, I think I see him. Is it him? Is it there? Is he in his underwear? It is sticky. It's sticky. Good. What up, Sticky Nation? I got clothes, son. I got clothes. What's going on, Sticky Nation? Say what's up to the people.
What's up, people?
Yeah. We all back. We all black.
Finally in it, son. Look, the hard work, the
basement. Oh my god!
They got a bar back there.
Oh snap!
Easy to do the phone.
Oh snap, nation! Oh, there goes Darth Helmato in the corner.
You probably can't see it. Let me see if you can. It's in that corner. I have my Lord of the Rings sword.
Oh, it's in the corner. Why is it? Why is baby in the corner?
You probably can't see it from here. Trust me.
Is there? Okay. Word. Ladies and gentlemen, happy holidays. We are so happy to be back. Last show of the season, man. Last show of the daggone year. Goodness.
I said it's over. 2015.
That's right. Big time year, man. Big time year. Goodness. So, like, tell the people, how was your holidays, man? I was showing people my gloriousness in the background.
Well, I just showed you guys my gloriousness. So you probably
The whole basement was your gloriousness. Oh, it's all glistening. Yeah, why'd you put baby oil all over it?
Right in front of there.
Your Rock Band Quattro.
Yeah, so that's basically my whole that was my Christmas week. I just finished like
I feel you.
Christmas Eve, I finished.
Oh, for real? Wow.
Working up for that day down here. I mean, it's just, you know, it's just been work. So got that done. And so I after I did that, I just, now it's video games, man.
Yeah.
Because last week, I didn't get to, I tried to play a little something, but I did do some Battlefront jump off. Oh, I had so much fun, man. I got on one of them speeders, I was go slow. Of course, it took me a while because I crashed into, like, the first time I was so open that I got one. I crashed into one of the land walkers, the AT-ATs.
Goodness.
I went smack right into it. I was on it for like a whole 5 seconds. And then I finally got, you know, I still can't figure out
where.
What is the freaking, is it like a kill streak to get the hero, or is it?
No, it's another icon.
It is, and I actually popped up next to the icon, but this, you know what, me, and this is where I got confused, because, like, I was in a match, and I was doing really well. I might have got, like, 15 kills in a row or something like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then right after I died, the freaking icon was right in front of me. I was like, ooh, I was open.
Yeah,
right?
That's what happens.
And I scooped it, and then, you know, I was getting loose, and the guy, my partner, you know, the partner they hit you up with,
yeah,
he's getting loose too, so he got one, and he became the emperor, and when you spawn on him, it made me be like one of his troops with the red joints on their shoulder.
Uh-huh.
And that dude was almost as hard to kill as you are if you're a hero. So that, I thought that was pretty cool, and like, I couldn't, after that, that was like the one time I got it, and I haven't gotten it again.
Wow.
What happened was, like, what was it? I think it was Christmas. Yeah, it was Christmas. The day after Christmas, we went out. It was that Saturday. We went out. My friend came over.
Mm-hmm.
We were playing a little bit. And after he left like around 11. I had to play to like 3 in the morning.
In the house, like 2 minutes.
Oh, okay. All right. There's Makita.
So that's what I did. I stayed up like all night playing that. So what I'm really dying to get onto is Fallout 4, because like I'm a like low level, level 11. So
hell yeah,
I'll probably be doing that like New Year's Day. That's all I'm doing.
Ah, dude, that's what I've been doing like for like the past week. Cause I went in, so I tried to be fresh, right? And I'm gonna tell y'all a little story. So, you know, I had to make room for the shiny new PS4, right? So I was like, all right, I'm going to take my PS3, I'm going to take my Wii, all my games, my controllers, even I had like one PS Vita game that I really didn't want that, you know, that had been laying around or whatever. So I took all that stuff, right, and I went in like two different sessions, right? The first session, I was going to take my PS3 and all my PS3 games and maybe like one or two Xbox One games that, you know, I knew I never played or didn't want to play anymore, and took them to Best Buy for like a little trade-in thing, right? Now, mind you, Best Buy doesn't have the, you know, oh so glorious 100% trade-in rubber dubs. They haven't had that for a while, unfortunately.
I know.
Right?
Look, the last time I saw it was like a couple of years ago.
No, I don't think it's been that long, but still, you know, it's been a while since I've seen it and actually had the opportunity to take advantage of it. So, you know, I went and I was like, you know what, they usually have pretty decent trade-in rates anyway. So I was like, you know, I'll probably get a good, I don't know, I couldn't even tell you what I thought I was going to get with it, right? Because it wasn't like the PS3 games that I had were big name, and plus they were PS3 games with the system that's, you know, been, I don't want to say obsolete, but basically obsolete for the past year and a half, 2 years, right?
Yep.
So I wasn't really expecting a whole lot. So PS3 and maybe I'd say 6 games or so. What do you think would be a modest trade-in value for it?
In 6 games?
Yeah.
If I was to guess, I would say about $80 tops.
Yeah, that's pretty close.
Because I would think the PS3 you get $50 for.
Yes. Yes. And then, you'd be right about that.
And then like, depending on the PS3 games, I'm not seeing. I mean, I'm just jumping out there and I'm guessing top 5-6 bucks per game, maybe less.
Much, you know, less.
You know, so that's why I'm saying, you know, so you got 6 games, I'm figuring maybe another $20.
Yeah.
Or, you know, 20, 30 bucks, that's why I said $80.
Yeah, it ended up, you know what it ended up being? It ended up being about $64 for everything. Yeah. So most of the games ended up being like 25 cents to a dollar.
Ooh. Yeah. I was way over with that $46.
And then, so I was like, okay, fine. That's, you know, PS3. I figured, and I knew I was gonna get less for the Wii, but I figured I'd at least get, like,
I forgot about the Wii. You got rid of the Wii too?
Yeah. I figured I'd get at least like maybe $10-$20 for the console, right? So today I got all hyper. And I was like, all right, let me take my Wii, my like 6 or 7 games that I have, and the one PS Vita game that I was going to get. I figured I'd get maybe tops $20. Right? Okay. That seems modest, right? So I went in, pulled out the Wii, and I didn't even bring out the games because I was thinking I was probably going to be able to get more for the games online than I probably would there.
Yeah, I'd probably agree with you there.
So, and then I started thinking about it. I was like, who the hell is buying Wii games right now? So I was like, you know what? Bump that. I'll just take them in. Which is what I did. I really wasn't worried about it. Let me see if I get Makita back in here real quick. So I went ahead and I did the dude basically told me, well, your PS Vita game, we don't buy PS Vita games anymore.
Really?
Yeah. So, you know, I think, you know, Sony's basically abandoned the Vita, and apparently everybody else has. So, the Vita's a dead console.
Yeah, the Vita, effectively. It wasn't that successful in the first place.
But. Yeah, it wasn't that successful in the first place. So, they just all out stopped buying used PS Vita games. So, PS Vita dead.
It's still with
the Vita. I just got the house. I will call you right back.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. So the other thing that we did that they gave me, the console itself, I think he said they basically gave me $3 for.
Whoa.
I want to say maybe one or two of the Wii games they didn't even want. They were like, no, we don't buy this one. No, we don't buy this one either. And the other, in like one of the Wii games, actually, they gave me like $1.30 or something like that for. And I was like, oh snap, that's a good one. Whatever one that was. And then, you know, like the other ones, they were like a 25 cents and a dollar or whatever. $1.30. Yeah, I was like, oh wow, $1.30. Woo. So all in all, with the Wii and 6 games, I ended up with about $5. And they don't even buy controllers. They were like, no, we don't buy controllers anymore.
Dude, I would have just took my Wii game and Wii just took it back.
I didn't want it around the house anymore. I really didn't. I was like, you know what? Just take it.
I would have donated it to some kid that would have had a lot more fun than freaking trying to buy it.
Yeah, I was like, here, just take it. Yeah, that was a Best Buy. Mm-hmm. So, word to the wise, if you've got anything that isn't a PS3 or Xbox 360, don't even worry about trading them. You're not going to get much anything for it. Which is probably, you know, that was probably a known fact to begin with.
Dude, that's why I keep my. I have a couple of Xboxes at home, so 360s.
Oh yeah, I'm never trading in my 360 because I've got too much stuff for it. But my PS3, I really didn't have much for it. You know
why I'm keeping the PS3? Because I have one of the old big joints.
I've got one of the newer ones. Because yeah, so, the old big joint has the backwards compatibility with it.
No, not anymore. When they do the software update, they can't match
it. Oh, really? They got rid of that too, even though it has the chip in it?
Long time ago.
Damn.
No accessy.
That's so what
I did
was
and I did this years ago. I put in a 320 gig hard drive in it.
Oh, okay. At
60, so boom, I got a 320 gig drive in there. So like, dude, I got PSN. The amount of free games they give away for PS3 is ridiculous. So I'll be downloading stuff right now. Like right now, I'm downloading Far Cry, something, whatever they had there, and a couple of other games that they had there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was like, I'm not even going to bother with any of that because I used to do that too. And I was like, I never played any of them.
Because I got all, now that I have my Blu-ray hooked up, I got all my main shit over here. So, like, when I'm in the bedroom, you know, and I get bored.
Ew.
You know?
We don't want to know about what you do in the bedroom and bored and stuff.
I get bored.
Ew.
So, you know, like, I'll play the, you know, because I keep the PS3 Pro Blu-ray playing.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
You know, so that's kind of worth it to me, too. So, like, I keep that, like, you know, when I want to watch a movie in the bed.
Mm-hmm.
Guardians, whatever, you know, something. So I got on Blu-ray, I can pop that in. And I don't even use the disc games anymore. You know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, you know what I actually like to? I keep the Uncharted series.
Gotcha.
So, like, I know they have the bundle for PS4, but I don't want to buy it. I already own them on the PS3, so, you know, I don't need it. So that's what I keep it for. And then I'll download the free game.
Hi.
Hey. What up?
Yo, I was trying to tell y'all from the thing. I had sent you a message on Facebook, and I was trying to tell you a thing. I was like, yo, I'm just walking back from the store. I'll be in a few minutes. And I was like, I wonder if he heard me because he called me a second time. But
I didn't say I was. Jason was deep in a conversation with me. I was like, so what's good, girl? What's good? We weren't listening to Thick Nation anyway. He was just talking his head off.
Nothing has been going on. Are we online?
Yeah, girl, we good. Oh, we doing it do.
Because I didn't see any videos, so I was like, oh, okay. Yeah, everything's been pretty good. The Christmas vacay was not too bad.
That's good. That's good.
I can't complain.
Yeah, because, you know, sometimes Christmas is always one of those holidays where I don't want to 100% assume that everybody's having a great time, because everybody doesn't always have a great time on the holidays. Holidays can sometimes be a hard time for some people, so.
Yeah, holidays, you know, death. Some people have seasonal depression, too. Mm-hmm. I have, like, a couple of friends that have seasonal depression.
Yeah, I've had
some
too. So,
it can be a little daunting, and I'm not really like a holiday person anyway, so mm-hmm. it's kind of like whatever for me, but this Christmas wasn't that bad.
That's good because I was kind of surprised, because this is, now that I think about it, since I've been married, this is probably the very first Christmas I've had actually at my house. You know, because most of the time I'm traveling. So okay. I go and have it at, you know, like, for the past, I want to say maybe 5 years or so, most of the time, we would have it in North Carolina. I would drive to North Carolina, I would spend the week or so with my mom, and we would have Christmas at her house in North Carolina. And this year my mom's having like operation on her foot. So she was like, oh, I don't want to do Christmas at the house this year because, you know, gonna be recovering and blah, blah, blah. So I was like, okay. So, you know, we'll do our thing. So, you know, we did our thing, had our Christmas here. Everybody was happy. I kicked the kids out, sent them to grandma's house this week. You know what I mean? So, you know, it's been quiet this week. Work's been quiet this week. It's been dope.
Yeah, a lot of people take the vacation from Christmas to New Year's.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. It's been mad quiet at work. I've been chilling at work going, la, 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 I'll do this one page and mm-hmm. I'm done for the day. All right.
Right, it's chillax, man.
Yeah, pretty much. Been a blast. But that's good. It's good. So did either one of y'all get anything, like, particularly, like, for yourselves or whatever that was particularly lovable that you're still like kissing yourself over?
Not that I can think of. I mean, I to be honest, I got some really nice gifts from people.
Mm-hmm.
But they weren't like video game related or anything like that. They were kind of just like crafts. I'm into like my whole like crafting thing, you know, like mm-hmm. draw, and I like to make homemade stuff. So that was kind of like the range of it. I mean, I've got everything from like money to candle making kits to a friend of mine bought me an oversized The Walking Dead number one.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's huge. Yeah. So that was pretty cool. I got like bracelets and stuff because I'm into like crystals and I think they're pretty. I like rock collecting. So that's been pretty good. I'm basically saving my coins because I'm probably gonna get an Xbox One probably sometime in March or something, depending on income tax, depending
tax season.
After I pay off everything, because I'm I'm trying to adult responsibly.
No.
Responsibility sucks. If there's any money after that, I'll probably get myself the Xbox One. Oh, that's not true. I did get something game related. So I don't know if you saw my video that I had put up. My friend for Christmas bought me this NZXT Phantom Tower because he knows that I'm building my next game.
Oh yeah, I saw that. Oh, so that was the case or something like that?
Yeah, that was just the case. I'm building everything from scratch.
Okay.
This is my very first computer that I've ever built.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So he was really like trying to support and everything. He's like, yeah, I know you're trying to build your own computer. And I was like, wow, I have great friends.
That is dope. That's cool.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah, man. See what else is going on there. Because you know me, I'll be all up in trying to get everything together. And next thing we know, everything's going like, hey, a bit. And and then I'm in that word. Oh man, let me at least try to put something up here while we talking. I'll put like some old Transformers or something like that on there. Let me try that. That's very visual. Over Thicky's face, over your face. Oh snap! Audio. There we go. So yeah, like I was telling Jade, I finally got my PS4-age going. PS1.
Oh, you got a PS4 now?
Yeah, I'm finally in there that swimwear now.
Oh, you gotta add me.
Yeah. I think I sent the invite.
Okay. Yeah.
I think I did.
When I get off the line tonight, we gotta play some games together. What game did you get?
Right now, I got the bundle. Like the big ass bundle is right here in my background. Let's see, what else did the thing have? It had, see the little shiny box. It had Super Star Wars, Star Wars Bounty Hunters,
okay.
Star Wars Racer Revenge, Star Wars Jedi Starfighter, and of course Battlefront. So I was messing around. I haven't messed around with any of the other little classic games that were on that list, but I played a little bit of Battlefront.
Wow. Yeah, just destroy everything.
Pretty much. Yep, just kind of fall over there. That's what happens. I did that, and then I went and bought Fallout.
Oh, okay, yeah, because I have Fallout. It's still in...
In the case.
No, do I have Fallout? I'm not sure if I have Fallout. No, I don't have Fallout. You know,
I'm thinking
of Far Cry.
Okay, yeah. So I went and got Fallout 4. And been building settlements left and right, scavenging, doing all kinds of junk and stuff all over it. So I'm definitely having a lot of fun with that. But yeah, that's about it. I haven't really decided what the next game, and that was like my Christmas present to myself, buying Fallout 4.
Okay.
So yeah, I haven't quite figured out what my next experiment in PS4age is going to be quite yet. I'm still debating because I've got like maybe like $40 in Best Buy gift cards or something like that where I can get something. But yeah. You know, with all these dang holiday sales and stuff like that, it's like a part of me is like, ooh, I want to get that. And I'm like, well, they might put it on sale in the next couple of days. So let me wait.
No, it's true.
So, you know, I kind of missed out on the opportunity to get Call of Duty because that was on sale last week. So.
I was thinking about possibly getting Call of Duty. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not a Call of Duty person. I haven't seriously played Call of Duty since Black Ops. Okay. I lost my love for Call of Duty after a while.
No.
But I'm thinking about getting it because I was watching one of my friends stream
mm-hmm.
on Twitch the other day, and I was like, okay, you know, it doesn't look too bad. But mm-hmm. I'm still like a Battlefront girl, like hardcore. So
right.
I'll probably get that. and then Fallout 4 really soon. Because I'm going to do some streaming, some more streaming soon. Because I've been taking a vacation. I was in school for a hot minute.
Yeah.
So now that I'm out of it, I'm trying to, like, get back in the role of it. It's kind of hard when you haven't been in it for a while. And it's, like, you're trying to, like, rev yourself back up. So I had, like, I did some video editing and everything today. So I'm, like, I got to jump back on, like, really, I don't know, just churning out videos and streaming. I gotta fix my schedule now that it's more open.
Yes, I kind of was like the same. I've kind of taken a little hiatus from both streaming and doing videos, like, for the past couple of months, really. So, and what I, and just like you said, once you get out of the swing of things, it's kind of like, you know, trying to get geared back up to start doing it and editing and piecing stuff together. Because I've been taking, you know, even though I have been playing a lot and not really streaming, I have been recording a lot. So it's like I've got all this footage and stuff, like, you know, kind of like we have here with the Transformers, where I'm like, okay, I need to do like a Let's Play or a you know, like an impressions kind of video for all these games I've been taking videos and stuff of, and just haven't really sat down and said, okay, today this is the day I'm gonna do at least two. You know, so I'm kind of stuck with that too.
The editing part is it can be the most tedious, you know, because it's like you have maybe, like, especially if you're doing like an impressions video, you'll have like 3 hours of footage, and then you're trying to like fit it into maybe 10 minutes, and it's like, okay, I gotta go through all this.
See, and good, if you footage, have your notes,
you have your stuff, notes on the side, and it's like, okay, I want to find certain pieces of media that match what the hell I'm talking about. It can be really tedious, but the outcome of it can be so rewarding.
Oh yeah. Once you finally get it done, you put it out there, it's always a blast. Definitely did. So yeah, it's definitely coming soon. We, you know, a little bit of everything from everybody coming soon. So hopefully, you know, we can get all that settled, get some good streaming going, because I know, like, on top of getting the PS4, I have been going a little bit, I don't want to say bad bonkers, but I have gone a little bit bonkers with, like, some of the holiday sales, because I went out and, let's see, what was the first game I bought? I think it was, you know, Bundle Stars and Humble Bundle. There's always something on sale and something that's the bundle for the week or whatever, right? So I ended up jumping on, I think it was Bundle Stars, and they had, I think it was the Square Enix bundle or something like that. And it had like a ton of really good games in there. Let me see if I can find a Bundle Stars Square Enix bundle, right? So I bought that. Was that last? I think that was last week. And they actually, now I think about it, I think they still have it going. Yeah, it's still going on for like another 5 days. But I paid maybe like $6 for it. And they had The Last Remnant, Life is Strange Episode 1. Tomb Raider 1, 2, and 3, Murdered Soul Suspect, Final Fantasy 14, Just Cause 1 and 2, Front Mission Evolved, Gyromancer, some other little small game that I've never heard of, Tomb Raider Anniversary, Tomb Raider Legend, Tomb Raider Underworld, and a coupon for 20% off Just Cause 3.
Okay.
And then I think if you pay a little bit more and pay like $9, you end up with Lara Croft and the Temple of Osiris.
Okay.
And then the original, well, not the original, but the other Tomb Raider reboot, before Rise of the Tomb Raider, the Game of the Year edition. And then the latest Hitman game called Absolution for like $9. All that stuff.
Wow.
So yeah, it's a pretty good bundle. So I picked that up. And then And then all of a sudden I saw the other game, the other RPG I was telling you guys about a few episodes ago called Pillars of Eternity. That was on sale for like, I want to say like $16 or $17 on Steam. So I picked that up because, of course, Steam is going bonkers with their holiday sale now. And like everything is on sale there.
Oh, by the way, I need to go look at that right now.
Yeah, I'm looking at it right now. It's like I wanted to get the Homeworld Remastered Collection. That's on sale for like $12. And that comes with like the original Homeworld, the original Homeworld 2, and the remastered Homeworld for like $12. They have, of course, Age of Empires 3 Complete for $8. Space Engineers, which is a pretty popular game nowadays, for $12.50. Mm-hmm. The other RPG that had been getting a lot of talk this year, Divinity Original Sin, for $27. They have, let's see, Wolfenstein The New Order for $9, Far Cry 3 for $7.50. Elder Scrolls Online for $23.99. Dark Souls 2 for $18.99. Black Ops 3 is for $44.99. Endless Legend, which is a really, really good game, for $10. They have Metal Gear Solid 5 for PC on sale for $40. H1Z1 for $13.
Oh, really?
Yep. Elite Dangerous for $14.99. Skyrim for $5.
What?
Yep.
Wow, I don't even like Skyrim. I might buy it.
Just about every Star Wars game known to man is on sale. Like, you could get Knights of the Old Republic for $3, Star Wars Force Unleashed for $6, Jedi Knight Jedi Academy for $3, Life is Strange for $2.50, Ark Survival Evolved, which is highly recommended even though it's not released yet, is out for $18.
I heard that game is good too.
Yes, very, very, very good. Rocket League is on sale for $13.99. Far Cry 4 for $20. Counter-Strike Go for $7.49. And those are just highlights. There's, you know, as they say, there's thousands of games that are on sale now. So, you know, check your, you know, just go on your wish list and check your wish list. More than likely, one of those games is going to be on sale. There's so much going on. So much. But yeah, it's the season, you know. Every system has their little holiday sale going, and for the most part you'll see those deals, I want to say, until like the first week of January. So by like the end of next week, I think most of these sales will probably be over for a while. So yeah. Get those gift cards out
now. Seriously. Yeah.
Get those gift cards out and just start using them, because before you know it, all those deals will be gone. Amazon was having a lot of great deals too. I saw a lot of good stuff on Amazon too. But most of, that's the weird thing though, most of the deals were all online. You know, I tried to go to stores to see if I saw some stuff, and most of them really didn't have much on sale, which was weird. So get it going, check it out. Maybe you'll get something that you've really been looking for on Sizzle.
Yeah, I'm about to get me up on there right now.
Yes, 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 yes. So, ladies and gentlemen, what I did want to kind of do, since this is our last show of the year, I figured what we would kind of do is kind of give you guys a bit of insight on what we thought were some of the best games of the year. Just a few generic categories and stuff that we suggest that everybody takes a look at and tries out and everything, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, all right. Here's a good category that I think would be good for all of us to kind of chime in on. For this year, what do you think was the biggest surprise in terms of a game that you didn't think was going to be good or that you had never heard of that turned out to be one of your favorite games of the year?
That's hard. Come back to me.
Okay. Jason, you on the spot? What about you?
I might have one or two. Dying Light, I thought, was a lot better than what I thought it was going to be.
True.
I actually enjoyed that game. I didn't go in with high expectations and I bought it. Pretty good.
Yes, it was.
That's a game I got to go back to. So that one was a surprise for me. I know there was a lot of hype around it, and people thought it was going to be good, and it actually was pretty good. But Dragon Age is
the Inquisition.
Because the last two they
went back there. That's very true.
Yeah, they kind of went down the a worse direction, like Mass Effect did, you know. I thought that's kind of what it was, but it was actually pretty decent. So those two are probably the ones I could think of right now that would probably be better than that.
Okay. Pretty good selection, pretty good. For myself, the biggest surprise for me was probably Ark Survival Evolved. Honestly, there weren't a whole lot of games that I felt, you know, when you saw the E3 trailer or something like that, that I was particularly hyper about. But, I take that back. I was kind of hyper when I saw some of the stuff for Metal Gear Solid. But when I saw Ark Survival Evolved, it just was kind of from left field. You know, when I watched the trailer, it pulled me in. You know, I was like, oh, wow, it's Jurassic Park as a video game, whatever. And then as the trailer went along, you know, I was like, holy cow, building the big forts. And then, holy cow, you're riding dinosaurs. And then, holy cow, what the hell is that dragon doing at the end of it? So it was like the dragon really sealed the deal for me. I was like, I want to play this game because I want to know why the hell there's a dragon running around with dinosaurs all over the place. And I jumped into that game, and you know, I was instantly pulled in. It was basically my entry level into survival games. You know, I had never played one of those like MMO style survival games where you just jump on a server and everybody's on the server trying to do the same thing, essentially just survive. And you know, it was my entry into that genre, and it pulled me in. I'm still looking for that opportunity to jump into H1Z1, and I forget what all the other ones are that, what is it, The Long Dark, I kind of want to play that now, and a bunch of other little survival style games, mainly because of Ark. And I mean, I've even talked about it on the show. I've introduced a coworker to it, and he and his son play that game every day, and they spend so much time together playing that game, building stuff, you know, battling other people that are on the server, you know, taming all these new dinosaurs, figuring out ways to build new things, figuring out new areas to find new resources. It's so big. There's so much you can do in that game, and it still isn't even released yet. So I'm kind of excited to see what they actually stamp as the final build, you know, before they actually release the game, because it's like every week I get the little newsletter and they're talking about another like three or four dinosaurs that they're releasing, as well as, you know, new things you can build and, you know, new aspects to the gameplay that just make it deeper and deeper. So I definitely say Ark Survival Evolved is my biggest surprise of the year, by far. All right. So, I'm hoping that gave you enough time to kind of sound off. You think you've got a good idea, Makita, of what is your biggest surprise of the year?
I don't think I had any surprises.
No surprises at all. No Until Dawn. I keep forgetting some of the other games you had been telling me about throughout the year also. Goodness, what was that other one? Because again, most of the games I remember you telling me about, they were kind of like either during the summer or like earlier this year, since that was when you were doing a lot more of the gaming and everything, but nothing really comes to mind.
No, not really. I can't really say, because like I've been, I don't know, there wasn't really anything that surprised me. You know what? Okay, so, but I'll go with Life is Strange, I guess. I mean, because I was kind of like,
pick one just to pick one, right?
Yeah, because the thing is, Life is Strange, I wasn't expecting it to be great. I mean, I was kind of tickled because of the fact that it was very like Dawson Creek-esque with a mix of Butterfly Effect.
Uh-huh.
But, yeah, it's, I don't know, it's like, it was really good for what it was, you know what I'm saying? Like, it had like a couple of twists, so.
Right. Okay, so Life is Strange. That's good. We got a selection. I can work with that. So let's flip it then. What games, and I'll start with you, Jay. What game this year do you feel was the biggest disappointment of the year?
Ooh. Biggest disappointment.
Yes, biggest disappointment. And what I can kind of do to, if you want me to, I'll try to see if I can find some nominees for you real quick. You want me to do that?
No, I got one.
You got one? Nah, I got that's one. Great. Go for
yeah,
it.
Yeah, no, I got one. And I'm glad I only got it. I got it for $29 when I bought it. Battlefield Hardline.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. So true. That's a big one.
Campaign was decent.
Mm-hmm.
That was probably the best part of that game. But multiplayer failed.
I mean, that failed.
Got, you know, that got beyond an F. That got like an I minus. it was bad.
Yep.
And I played through the campaign, most of it. I didn't finish it, but after that, I couldn't do the multiplayer. I wanted to like it, but I couldn't.
Yeah.
That was a big disappointment, because I like Battlefield, so.
Yep, that was a big nominee for myself as well.
So I would probably have to go with that. I think everything else that I thought might have been bad, that was bad, I stayed away from.
Mm-hmm.
The one that I almost got caught with was The Order.
Yep, that was a nominee I had up there.
That one, I heard that was pretty bad.
Yeah.
I saw it for $10. And I might just get it just to play it, but I really wanted to play it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not no rush for it, so I'll wait. Maybe when I get to 6, I'll get it.
What about you, Makita? Was there anything that you like anticipated during the year, but you quickly decided not to even give it the time of day because of something you heard about it or saw about it throughout the year?
Wow. I feel like this was, oh man.
And if you want, I can do the same thing I offer Jay. I can go through a few nominees throughout the year.
Yeah, do that for me. Yeah. Okay. It's like,
I know early in the year, and I know neither one of you guys were particularly impressed with the beta for this game, but this was definitely one of the big ones for me at the beginning of the year that ended up being a big disappointment, and I decided not to buy it because of it. Evolve. Saints Row 4 was another one that was kind of a disappointment for a lot of people. I wasn't particularly interested in it, but I know a lot of people were kind of sad about how that one turned out. Let's see. I've heard a decent amount of people kind of complain about the Telltale Games version of Game of Thrones, saying that though they enjoyed it, they were kind of miffed that the episodes, you know, unlike some of the other titles, that the Game of Thrones one seemed as if there weren't that many endings. You know, it was like most of what happened in that game all came down to a very slim, you know, in terms of slim pickings in terms of what would actually happen throughout the game. So I've heard some people be a little bit disappointed with that. What was another big one? Sid Meier's Starships, I heard, was a huge disappointment. For all those that love like SimCity and strategy games, they were very disappointed at how shallow the Starships, you know, version or game was when it was released. Like Jason said, The Order 1886, that was a big one. That's like the first quarter of the year. Let's see, what else was another one? For some reason on lists, I keep seeing people say Hotline Miami 2 was kind of a big disappointment for people. Definitely Hardline, Battlefield Hardline was a big one. Let's see, where's my list? Of course, Star Wars Battlefront is on a lot of people's lists. For some people, well, yeah, mainly because, you know, it's kind of got the whole lose its appeal after a few months of gameplay. And a lot of people were just miffed that most of the future content is going to be paid DLC rather than them supporting it with free stuff, as well as paid DLC. And I think they kind of changed that up and said they're going to try to add some more to it. But,
well, yeah, I could see that. I mean, that game shouldn't have been a $60 game. It should have been a
$50. Right. And I think that's what they were saying. They were like, if it wasn't $60, they'd be fine with it. But they were like, for it to be.
Actually, I was lucky because I'm a Costco shopper. They had it go for $49. So that's when you bought it.
Yeah,
that was like the first week it came out, so they must know something that everybody else don't know.
Right. Yeah.
And I would agree because the little bit I've played of it, like those local matches, that's about it. After I've gone through those a couple times, why would you want to play them again?
Yeah, it's a little bit on the shallow side in terms of stuff in it.
And the multiplayer, they don't have too many modes.
Right. Yeah. I mean, it's still shiny, pretty, sounds great, plays great, but, you know.
Oh, man, it's probably one of the better-looking games I've seen. I mean, when you're on Endor, I think it's incredible.
Yep. Also, I've heard a lot of people say that Mad Max was a big disappointment. A lot of people were looking forward to that. I've heard some people say Rock Band 4 was a disappointment just because.
It came out? It was another Rock Band?
Yeah, girl.
Actually, I can definitely attest to that. That it does. The music lineup sucks.
Yeah, a lot of people on top. Well, not even just the music lineup, but I heard a lot of people just say, you know, they can forgive the bad initial playlist, but they were upset that they couldn't use the music, all of the music that they had bought from the network on the previous editions on this edition. And you know,
that's a biggie too.
Yeah, Harmonix said that they're trying to get all the licenses and everything so that they can use it on this one, but you know, to actually have to release the game and not be able to use it is kind
of
big.
BS, because once you get the license, you got it.
No, that's not true. You only got it for that one game. You don't get it for everything. They have to renew the licenses for every game that they do.
I don't That one sounds kind of fishy to me. I wouldn't think that would be the still of the piece.
No, it is. That's why they couldn't, you know, that's why they had to go back and they had to, you know, they have to renegotiate stuff for Rock Band 4 to make them available.
Yeah, as far as I go, that's really, I can't forgive the line because it sucks. It's not Rock Band, it's Pop Band. That's basically what it is.
Yeah, right.
I don't have anything against Bruno Mars. I actually like him, but, like, dude, he doesn't need to be a part of that main thing.
Nope. And I heard one of the new songs that they're releasing, Justin Bieber. And I was like, come on, man, really?
Yeah, right. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Like the other ones, If you wanted to go get yourself some Lady Gaga or whatever, you can go right ahead and go do it.
Mm-hmm.
But you pay your dollar money or whatever that money makes sense for the song, whatever it is.
Yeah.
But part of that main playlist, it should be a rock band. And so,
yeah,
that's where I had you. The beef a little bit, and I probably get about 50% of the songs.
Okay, that's not bad.
It wasn't horrible, but I guess it depends on what you actually,
yeah, it depends on what songs what you, actually, you know, right, what you actually like is whether or not it's available, I guess. Yeah, so
I think that's the case, but from what I could see, they had a pretty decent amount of stuff there. I think some of it was new and some of it was just what I thought was shitty too is like they had some of the songs from Rock Band 2. You had to pay to download them.
Yeah. You're like, I already got these though. What the?
Yeah, I already have those. You know how it is.
Yeah. And probably the last little bit of nominees I stuck on the list, and this is just because, and these are both great games, mind you, but this is because of the diehard fans, you know, the fans that are really hardcore into the storyline for these games. A lot of people, well, I won't say a lot of people, a decent number of people have mentioned that they were extremely disappointed in the campaign or main story for both Halo 5 and Metal Gear Solid. Despite both of those games being, you know, rated really high and being really great games, storyline wise, I heard people were upset because they felt like on Halo. So, for instance, on Halo 5, a lot of people said they felt miffed because the like commercials and the way that they kind of said that, oh, you know, find the truth, you know, Master Chief is gone rogue, or has he really gone rogue, and what's going on with Master Chief, and find the truth, you know, that kind of thing, that the main story really blasts through that mystery like in the first few missions, and the rest of the game, you know, you found the truth already, you're really just going through the rest of the game, and that commercial really didn't really give you a good teaser for what the real storyline of Halo 5 was.
Yeah, but I think the thing
that people, it could be, but I heard that was a lot of people's gripe, that they were like, they felt like they were led astray in terms of what the real storyline for Halo 5 really was. And that on top of that, they didn't really like the storyline campaign for Halo 5.
Yeah, but like Halo, like just like all the other shooter games, like their storylines are iffy.
Well, no, this is, I'm not talking about just regular people, you know, just playing through it or whatever, that understand that the campaigns are iffy. I'm talking about the diehard, they love Halo so much they read all the books kind of people. You know, those are the ones that are basically saying, yo, this, you know, in comparison to all this storyline is, but, and what they told us this was going to be, this wasn't really what it was. That's the only reason why I put that up there. Yeah. Same thing with Metal Gear Solid. I heard a lot of people say that the main story for Metal Gear Solid is so fragmented and disjointed, and that the ending really wasn't that great. They weren't very impressed with the storyline for Metal Gear Solid either.
Wait, the one that just came out?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I've heard some people say that. Now, mind you, I love that freaking game. With that said, I can barely tell you what the main storyline for this game is. Now, that's mainly because I'm not a, you know, I'm not a liquid snake or metal snake or, you know, plastic snake fan. I couldn't tell you who's who or what's what, but, you know, that game, dude, I want to say that's probably the one game I've spent the most time playing this year, but there's probably a few others I've probably spent a little bit more time, but I've spent a ton of time playing that game, and that is a phenomenal game. Kojima did a bang-up job with that game. I love it, I love it, I love it. But with those nominees out there, I'll throw my little selection in there, and then I'll see what you come up with, Nikita. But for myself, I basically selected Evolve because...
you know what? That should be my pick, but go ahead.
Yeah, because I got open when, you know, I got open playing the beta because I love being big bad monsters and eating people and throwing and tossing people around and everything. And that part of the game is a blast. I love it. I enjoy doing that. But the balance that they had for that game, as well as the lack of modes for that game, when it comes to like the hunters and how much work the people that were the hunters had to put into in order to take down the monster, mm-hmm. it just wasn't anywhere near balanced well. They tried too hard to make this, well, they kept billing this game as the game that they were going to launch into esports or something like that and competitions. Oh, and it's so far from that, it's ridiculous, you know. And then on top of that, like the DLC that they were adding, I heard people say the DLC was pointless. You know, the extra monsters, some of the extra monsters almost look like they were skins of existing monsters, or they really didn't add anything to, you know, the gameplay, and that some of the new hunters, you know, really weren't that great either. And, you know, it was like, okay, they added like two or three hunters, one map, and one monster for each DLC pack, and people were just pissed off. You know, they were like, this is so horrible, you know. And they even tried to spruce it up a bit with like a new mode called evacuation mode that was supposed to be, you know, the replacement, I guess you could say, for the lack of the campaign mode. But the way they went about doing that was all wrong as well. It just didn't work out. You know, the concept seemed like it was pretty decent, but, you know, execution-wise, it just didn't pan out very well. Very disappointed. I ended up buying it, though, when it was on sale at Gamefly. I got it from Gamefly for, like, $10. So, for $10, it was worth it. But outside of that, it was a huge disappointment for me. Huge, huge, huge.
Yeah. Evolve was one of my biggies that I was kind of hoping would be bananas. Like,
right.
I didn't expect it to be such a flop as it was, you know, because right. I would watch people play on Twitch and stuff, and mm-hmm. I was like, what the fuck is this game? Like, it got boring really fast for me. Yeah. And I was glad that I didn't spend the money on it, so mm-hmm. I said that's a disappointment. I mean, oh man, I feel like it would be a big disappointment if I had actually bought the game.
Okay,
but
yeah.
I think what became this is gonna seem petty, but I don't think it's petty. I think that a game that routinely disappointed me as it went on was H1Z1, and it's not for the reason that you think, because it's actually a pretty sound game as far as like. Well, not graphics is concerned, because it could definitely use some work on graphics, but like the concept of the game was really great.
Mm-hmm.
But what really pissed me off is that no matter how many updates they had, they never had an option to make a black person. Like, there
really?
They never had an option to make a black person. It was like, Okay. Customization.
I thought they did, but now that I think about it, it wasn't H1Z1 that did have the great customization. It was what was the other one? Rust or something like that, right? Okay. Yeah, I think that's what it was called. Because that was the one they kept writing the article about that people were pissed off because you couldn't select what race or whatever your character was when you dropped in.
Right.
Yeah. So I'm sorry. Go ahead.
But when I went on there, I was like, okay, this is the alpha. And they were like, oh, customization. So at first, I thought, like, you know, you can go in there, you can change the eyebrows and stuff like that. But it was basically like, normal face white guy, normal face white woman, and angry face white woman, and angry face white man. And I was like, okay, you know what, I'll go with this. They'll be doing some updates soon because I refuse to believe that some black people didn't survive the fucking zombie apocalypse, right?
Right.
So
little did you know, all black people got eaten.
Right.
They like and dark then, meat, girl. Come on.
Yeah, they did all these freaking updates. They even went as far as made black people zombies, but they never gave you the choice to make your character black, and that pissed me off, and I just stopped playing it. I was like, y'all are really just ignoring the fact
really
that there's
right
a ton
now.
Of your a ton of your fans are black. This is really OD now. Like, y'all got all these goddamn updates, and y'all adding black people as zombies, but you're telling me you can't. I would rather have them show some type of effort, even if it was a lazy effort, and you just threw black skin on a white,
right
on a white
character,
person.
Right? Yeah.
I can't even have that. Damn.
Nope. Mm-mm.
Yeah. So that was my disappointment, I guess.
Wow. Yeah, that's pretty rough. Pretty rough. But how was the gameplay otherwise? Because I know I remember seeing you play that for a while.
The gameplay is awesome. Uh-huh. Like the community itself on the not the player versus player, because I refuse to play on that. The environment versus player, the community is really nice. People are just like, you know, they're into like helping each other and stuff, and you know, you build like these communities with strangers. I've had people like stop by and say, hey, do you need a ride? Because you know, they have cars and stuff, and I'm like, yeah,
oh,
you can ride to this section and stuff.
Nice.
And they were like, oh, we're in this section. There's some people that make up like little bases where you come and, you know, they'll drop stuff off. And they're like, the only thing that we ask is that you leave some things, you know, for other players. This is a space for other people to, like, kind of come and you know, get items, get better items if they can. And, you know, just, you know, leave your weaker items if you want and stuff. And it was, like, a really, really nice community. The people are just great. I can't complain. It's just, it's awesome.
Interesting. So, yeah. H1Z1 and, well, I guess you kind of chose two for that one, right? H1Z1 and Evolve, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, how about what was probably, and I'm sure we'll all have to guess at this one, what your most played game of the year was?
Ooh. I mean, I guess it would be the same thing as H1Z1. I used to come home from like 16-hour shifts, jump on the computer and play it, and then be like, yeah, let me get this nap in for 30 minutes and then head to work. You know, like, it's just a really good, it's addictive.
Yeah.
I guess, yeah, that's the only game that I really went hard on, besides Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only game that I really, really went hard on. Because this year, you know, I guess... I've been kind of disappointed about like new gen games. I was expecting for like a bunch of games to come out where I was just like, yo, I got this PS4 now.
Right.
I'm gonna be spending my money like how I used to, and you know, every game I have to have it. And now it's just like the only thing that I'm really looking forward to is the new Final Fantasy that's coming out, what, like 2017, I guess.
But, if that. Yeah, I'm not even certain. Did they actually drop a date for that?
Not that I heard.
Right, exactly. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not even certain if that's really what's going to do it. But, yeah, okay. So, what about you, Jay? What has probably been your time suck of the year?
My time suck of the year has been Witcher 3. That's it. I've probably pumped about 300 hours into it.
Right.
That's it. That's the only game that I play
a lot of.
Yeah, I actually 2 months straight I didn't play anything else. I just played them.
Mm-hmm.
And when the DLC came out, I probably spent another 30 hours on it.
Wow, I'm trying to think. The only reason why I say this is probably the game I spent the most time playing is because some of the other games that I know I spent a lot of time playing, I didn't really play until like the last half of this year. I'd probably have to say I spent the most time playing Battlefield 4 this year. Honestly.
Hmm.
Just mainly because at the beginning of the year, there really wasn't a whole lot in the way of really big games. You know, I played a decent amount of Dragon Age, but I got kind of miffed with the storyline because it wasn't as epic as I wanted it to be.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't finish that. And then at the same time, Witcher 3 came out, and I kind of rolled into the same point with that. You know, I got into it, and then I got to a point in the storyline where it kind of lost me, and something else caught my eye, so I never finished that one either. And I kind of had gamer's ADD throughout most of the year. I'd have like a month where I'd play one game a majority of the month, but I would always come back to Battlefield 4 at least once or twice during every month and play a lot. Like, over one weekend, I would get back into Battlefield 4, and I'd just be like, you know what? I love this game. And just, you know, and I'd go hard and play a whole lot of, like, one of the different DLC packs, whether it was, like, because I can't remember. I think they released at least two or three, like, map packs or maps or something like that for Battlefield 4 just this year. You know, it has been out for, what, 2 years? Something like that? At least 2 years? Can you remember? Yeah, it's been at least 2 years it's been out. So I definitely have to say Battlefield 4 is probably the one I spent the most time on throughout the year. Probably with NBA 2K 15 as a close second. Spent a lot of time playing that too. Okay. So we've got biggest surprise, biggest disappointment, most played game. Not those two categories. Not everybody played those. How about RPG of the year? I think I already know what Jason's is already.
Well, I'm debating between two of them.
Oh, you're debating. Okay. So I'm pretty certain I know which two those are. So yeah, which do you think has the edge over the other and why?
Right now, only because I haven't gone through the whole game yet, and I can't pass judgment, so Witcher 3 obviously is the only one in my mind, because that game to me, it had the fighting of an action RPG, plus you had, you know, all the fun RPG elements.
Mm-hmm.
It had good story. It had the main quest. I mean, the main quest story was good, but I enjoyed a lot of the side quest stories, and they were really, I mean, there were some of them that I just thought were better than the main quest stuff. It had tons of areas for you to explore. I mean, it had, what was it, three continents you could go on. You know, you had that. I mean, there were a lot of treasure and looting to find. You know, there was a lot of, you know. The only thing I would have wanted was, like maybe you could get, like, a, you know, maybe build a house or something and just store a lot of your stuff.
Nah, yeah.
I think it was missing that. You know, that
yeah.
I mean, they added in the DLC where you can do, like, in Witcher 2, where you could put gear into like a storage box, and then you have to find in another area that have the same storage box. It's kind of stupid, but
They needed something because there's a lot. Yeah, you're traveling so much. And it's always good to have some place to go home to.
Right. And store stuff. I mean, there's some stuff that I didn't want to get rid of, but because I have better gear, I had to get rid of them. I had to end up selling them. And sometimes I couldn't even sell stuff because it's like, you know, with any of you get stacked and you start getting really good items, the people you sell to, they can't even buy
them. They don't have the money. Yeah.
So, you know, that's the reason why I think I think Fallout 4 definitely has the potential to beat it out. I just haven't finished the game yet, or I haven't filled. I'm still a low level. You know, I've been doing like scavenging and stuff like that, and I'm at that pivotal point where I'm carrying too much shit. So, you know, like, and the thing is with your junk.
Yeah,
I'm not at the point in the game right now. What I know, you know, when you get that good feel of what your junk is, whether it's, you know, you're gonna need all that crap for crafting.
Right? Oh, so, well, that's the thing. When you get all that stuff, you're supposed to store it at the workshop. You transfer all of it there, and then once you get high enough and everything, you can link all of your settlements so that they can all share the workshop junk. So that if you go from one place to the other, you don't have to say, oh snap, I got all the steel over at such and such, I gotta go send the steel over to this settlement.
Exactly. So see, that's where I'm at right now. See, I haven't gotten to a point where I even know that.
Yeah. That's where you have to get to.
Right. So like, you know, I got the dog. I finally made it to Diamond City. You know, over there. So like, you know, I've hit a couple of the settlements, but like not enough to like know all that stuff, you know. Like I haven't gone everywhere yet. So
Yeah.
I'm still getting like hijacked by bees that I can't get past.
Stupid bloat flies,
And you know, like you half kill them and then they go psycho in you and then they freaking sting the shit out of you with that on the phone.
Yeah.
So like, that's what I said. I gotta put a little bit more into it. You know?
Yep.
But I think those two are probably going to be my nominees for RPG.
Okay. It was a pretty easy selection for myself. Only because I really didn't play a whole lot of RPGs this year. I'm playing Fallout 4. I'm enjoying it. But I don't think I would put it over the game that essentially Witcher 3. I haven't had a chance to play Pillars of Eternity, which I heard is an excellent RPG that PC gamers have been raving over all year. So it would probably have a bit of a fight, I'm certain. But again, I just bought it, so I haven't had time to jump into it.
Right, and I think that's probably where you and I are in the same boat. It's like, you know, I'd like to say Witcher 3 because that's the one I put the most time into, so I have an opinion on it.
Yeah.
I can't say that Fallout 4 will be better than it because I just haven't found the time.
Right,
which I plan to do in the next, you know, couple weeks. So now all this is done. You know, I'm bringing my computer and stuff over probably next week.
I'm
gonna set my stuff up. So now I can just like, you know, spend my time making videos,
making
the stuff. I don't have to go looking around for shit. I can upload right away. So
Yep. What about you, Makita? Any RPGs stand out for you this year?
I didn't play any RPGs this year.
That was an easy category for you, right?
Yeah, I didn't play any RPGs this year at all.
Okay. All right, that'll probably change next year. It'll change next year.
I hope so.
All righty. So... Yeah. So, probably the biggest and best category of all. Keep it simple. Game of the year. I think this one should be an easy one for everybody, but it'll be interesting to see what everyone says. What about you, Makita? What is your game of the year?
You know what? I'm not even gonna take into. I can't really say because you know, I really didn't do as much game playing this year because, you know, I was in school. Yeah, but, I mean, I guess...
And it could very well just be the best game that you played this year. It doesn't even have to be a game that was released this year or anything. Just what was your best game that you played this year?
I guess the only thing I could really say to that kind of hit me in my chest was Life is Strange. I mean, the endings kind of sucked. But just the concept of the story in general it was pretty good. Like that was my
outstanding. Had you hooked while you were playing it?
Yeah, that was my game of the year. That was the only game I spent a lot of time playing in between school. Mm-hmm. I couldn't play H1Z1 because it took up a lot of my time. I had to like cut it in general because of school and for the fact that they just did not have any black characters. It was just becoming an insult. It was like a conscious slap in the face. So
yeah.
I left it at that. So I guess Life is Strange would be my game of the year.
Okay. How about you, Jason?
Same game, man. Witcher 3. It's like Witcher 3? Best. It's. I think it's gonna be the movie. That's my.
Yeah, a lot of other outfits have definitely chosen it. Yeah, as their game of the year. Yeah.
And you know what? It hasn't even. It has one more DLC coming.
Mm-hmm.
I would probably go with that. I mean, like I said, the only other one that I think may go behind it that was actually, you know, that lived up to the hype is Fallout 4. That's it.
Okay.
Not even Dragon Age. Dragon Age just, it was good, but it got repetitive after a while. It was the same stuff.
Yeah. I would agree. So, for my game of the year, this one was kind of a surprise for me, but I really thought about it, and my game of the year was probably Metal Gear Solid. Which, when I kind of thought about it, was kind of surprising, mainly because, like I said before, I couldn't really tell you a whole lot about the storyline, but, what I did notice as I was playing that game is that this game is not only huge, but there's just so much that you can do both offline and online on this game. And there was such really, really great balance between the modes and interaction between the modes, both offline and online, that, you know, you really don't see in games at all. You know, I mean, to kind of start off, I mean, I know some people that started off playing Metal Gear Solid were like, oh, it's kind of repetitive because all you're doing is going from base to base. You're stealing all the resources or soldiers or whatever. And, you know, that's really all they run around and go and do. But which is what you can do. But of course, the intent is to kind of push the story along. So as you push the story along, it felt like every maybe 3 or 4 missions or so that you would finish, it would open up another way or dimension of the game. You know, like at a certain point, you open up the main mercenary base, right? And then after you open up the main mercenary base, once you research enough, you are able to steal really big resources or really big weapons from the bases. Once you do that, you can finally start stealing tanks and other stuff. And as you are able to steal and add to your main mercenary base more, there's all these little missions, kind of like you remember on Black Flag and on like Assassin's Creed Black Flag, as well as on like Assassin's Creed 3, where you could take all of your mercs or the people that were on your team and you could send them on missions by themselves. And then they would bring back money and resources if they won or if they did something really well. You know, you're able to do that sort of thing with your mercenary crew in Metal Gear as well. And as your level goes up, the difficulty of those missions that you send your people goes up as well, because the rewards that they will bring to you increase as your level and, you know, your power or whatever in the game increases as well. And then, you know, at another point, it opens up what they call the forward operating bases, which really was what they showed at E3 when they were like, oh, you can invade your friend's base and steal some of their resources, right?
Right.
And honestly, that took a good 20 missions in the game before you could get to that point. And I was telling Jay, I was like, yo, I don't even want to review it until I get to that point where I'm able to go and infiltrate somebody else's base and try to steal their resources and stuff like that. And as I started playing that, I recognized what I was talking about before, that they have, Kojima put a lot of thought behind making certain that the bases that you're infiltrating online aren't the main bases that you are tending to in the single player mode. So, you know, he didn't want it set up where if you go in and you play the game a lot for a month and then you come back like 2 weeks later, all of a sudden somebody's come in and stolen all your people and all your resources and stuff, right? He made certain that he set it up in a way that you can only steal like a fraction of what your total resources are in the single player mode. You know, and that you can allocate the right defenses, you can buy insurance for the stuff that you, you know, for the stuff that you can lose on those forward operating bases. If you go in and infiltrate somebody else's base, it's a really good and quick way to get a lot of money and some good, you know, personnel from here and there. And the other thing was, it's hard. You know, it's not easy to go into somebody else's base and steal their personnel and actually make it back out alive. Because the people that you use, you can use, you know, of course you can use Snake, or you can use some of the other guys that you picked up along the way in the single player game. And they all have different skills. So if you take, you know, one of your best guys that's your mercenary in the single player mode on one of these infiltrations and he gets killed, he's gone. You know, you have to go and replace him with somebody else. So there's just so much depth in all the different modes and all the different ways you can play this game. And that's not even including the Metal Gear Solid Online mode. And that's like completely separate from, you know, the huge open world game that you spend all your time playing already. And of course, I think most people that are big Metal Gear Solid fans will remember that Metal Gear Online was like a separate game by itself on, I think, like the PS2 or something like that. It might have been PS3, I can't remember. But instead of making it its own separate game that you have to pay more money for, they included it in this game. And so, like, Jay, you remember when you were wondering why it was they made you create your guy's picture at the beginning of the game?
Yeah.
Because, you know, basically throughout the whole game you're playing as Snake, so you're like, okay, why the hell did I just make this guy? Well, the guy you make is the guy you play as in Metal Gear Solid, excuse me, online. And that's kind of weird. I don't know why they did it that way either, because it has nothing to do with the single player mode, but that's what they chose to do.
Yeah, it threw me off there for a while. I'm like,
Well, yeah, it threw everybody off. And, you know, I'm still wondering why they did that. You know, I'm thinking maybe there's something in the game that allows you to maybe use that character in the single player game. At a certain point,
the game, you take Snake's face off, and then it's your face on it.
Oh my god! Yeah, disgusting. Yeah, something like that. You know, pull a Mission Impossible and just rip the face off and go, "Ha! It wasn't Snake in your face." But you know, it's got so much content, and there's so much stuff in there on both online and offline that I'm 100% certain I'm going to be playing the game for a long time, just because of the way, you know, the game itself is structured like one of the old games that I used to play all the time called Mercenaries. You know, and I used to love playing that game, running around, blowing up tanks, you know, pulling out really big rocket launchers, destroying a whole base and then running, you know, because they're sending an attack chopper after you or something like that. There's just so much that goes on in this game that you can use from the buddy system. You know, you can have a dog or your horse or a mech or a sniper or something, you know, to go with you on all these different missions, and they can be customized, their weapons can be customized and everything. There's just so much going on in this game, and I love the way it all, you know, it's very organic the way everything affects each other in the game, both in the single player mode and the online mode. There's just a lot going on, and I love it. It's a very, very, it's well worth the $60. Definitely worth $60. And that's hard to say, I guess you could say, for a lot of games nowadays, you know?
Yeah, they feel like $20 games.
Right, exactly. So yes, yes, yes. Game of the year. What did we say? We had Life is Strange, Witcher 3, and Metal Gear Solid 5. The Phantom Menace Pain, of all kinds of stuff. But it's, I would definitely have to say, just in terms of the lineup of games this year, you know, if at the beginning of the year you would have told me I would have been into the games that I played this year, I wouldn't have believed you. Honestly, at the beginning of this year, I didn't think there was going to really be anything I wanted to play.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I knew I was going to want to play Halo because that was coming out. You know, you guys had hyped up Witcher 3, so I knew I was going to want to play that. But aside from those two games, honestly, I really didn't think there was going to be much of anything else that I was going to be into this year. And I was pleasantly surprised, just like Jason, with like stuff like Ark Survival Evolved or Dying Light or Metal Gear Solid or... You know, even some of the little indie games that I've been playing this year, I've been impressed with.
Me too. Trials of Light, I've been playing that Chariot game. That's been playing. What else? There's a couple more I can't remember right off the top of my head, but I played quite a few of those.
Yep. Same here.
Yeah, and they were actually better at some point, you know. I didn't have like my go-to games. Like right now, I got my go-to, like my Halos and Black Ops 3, you know, those are just my little, but I need to play something like that. I actually got to jump back on Dying Light, mentioning that.
I'm stuck at the ending. I got to the ending.
Do not spoil it for me. I'll kill you.
Well, that's the thing. I haven't beaten it yet. I'm at a point in the game where they say, hey, you know, once you go past this point, you can't go back. It's like, you know, once you go past this point, you can't go to the open world portion of the game anymore. You know, so I was like, oh, snap. Okay, I don't want to do that quite yet. Exactly. Yeah. I was like, no. Let me go back and just hoard and, you know, get a whole bunch of resources and stuff before I go through this. So that's kind of where I left it until I decide that I want to, you know, do like a streaming session and say the end of Dying Light finally and just, you know, play through until I get to the very, very ending of the game. So,
The thing I think made it really good for me and surprised me, because some of the game missions are a little repetitive and the little, you know, the little kill packages. When it turns night, shit gets hot.
Quick.
And that's where the game gets crazy and fun real fast. It keeps you on edge a little bit. You know, you're like, oh shit, I gotta make it back to base. When the sun's going down, you better hurry up.
yes. And I'm telling you, there was actually a point in that game where I finally got strong enough to be able to survive
at night.
But even with that, you know, because those things are hard as hell to kill. Yeah. But even with that, even if you kill one, what I finally realized quickly is that you may take down one, but as you're taking down that one or two, you know, there's like three or four more that are on their way that you don't recognize until they're up on you.
And then you better know where your little safety spots are. You know what? Sometimes when I can get it, I'll be like, run up there, jump in the bed, be like, you know what?
Yeah, and of course, getting that, what was that, the grappling hook. Dude, I used to go bonkers playing with that grappling hook. It saved my life so many times. Ugh, that thing is awesome. Love the grappling hook. So yeah, there's been a lot of great games that really surprised me this year. I mean, everything from like Broforce as a little indie game that came out of nowhere.
That was fun.
That they added a whole lot to that game after they had, it was kind of cute at first when it first hit, early access, but they added so much to that game and then they finally released it. And then games like Galaxy, which was like a little small asteroid style shooter in the form of Robotech, the TV series. Gauntlet surprised me. The remake for Gauntlet is fantastic. I enjoyed playing that, even though I feel like that game was probably 10 years too late.
The Gauntlet, it's fun.
It's just that, after playing Diablo 2 and 3, you're kind of like, there's not enough loot in it.
Yeah, that's kind of what it is. It's like a stripped down version of it.
Yeah, it's fun, but it's a few years too late.
I played like 4 of the levels and I'm like, eh.
Right, yeah, you don't really want to go too far and play through the whole thing.
Yeah, it wasn't worth my whatever how many hours, it was probably 4 or 5 hours.
Yeah. What was the other game? Rebel Galaxy that I played, Beyond Soul. I had a lot of streaming sessions with both of those games that were a lot of fun. Sword Coast Legends, even though it was kind of underwhelming when I was playing it, from what I've heard, they've added a whole lot to it when it first, after the first like month of it being out, that it, has redeemed itself. There was another little game called Windward that I played that was kind of like the old Sid Meier's Pirates game where you're a little ship and you're doing all the, fighting pirates and taking on other pirate ships and stuff. That was a whole lot of fun. Windward was the name of that one, which was really good. What was the other one? Combat sim game with the vector style graphics called Vector Thrust that I played was kind of fun. Even the little weird narrative style game called Sunset that I played was interesting.
I heard that was really weird.
Yeah, it's weird because you play as a maid. And it's supposed to be where, you're supposed to make decisions between spying on this guy that's supposed to be like a Brazilian, I don't know if he's a government official or like criminal mastermind or something, I don't know. Okay. But, you're supposed to, you've got a limited amount of time each day to either clean up or spy on him by looking through his stuff. And as the game goes along, you make all these different decisions as to whether or not you help the resistance because you're in Brazil or something like that.
Okay.
And, I was playing through it and I kind of got tired of, cleaning and doing dishes and looking through the dude's books and stuff and saying, he may be doing something shady. Let me go over here and finish, vacuuming and using Febreze on the rug. So, I was like, I'm tired of doing that. But, it was still an interesting concept because, it's a different style game. It's not your typical first person shoot 'em up. It's your first person clean 'em up.
Yeah.
It's weird like that. So, but it was out there. It was different. Then there was the other 4X strategy game I played called Star Drive 2. Which is very reminiscent of Masters of Orion for those who love strategy games like that. That was another good one. Of course, the one game that I think took everybody by storm on PC, which was Rocket League.
Yeah.
I didn't really play it.
There were a lot of people playing that game. I just couldn't. I didn't even bother buying it, even when it was free.
Yeah.
I was like, no, I'm not getting into this.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's a simple enough concept. You know, Micro Machines soccer is basically what it seemed like to me. But you know, it kind of grew on everybody. They've got all kinds of esports leagues and stuff playing it now. It's done so well, so. You know, I would have put that as my big surprise game of the year, but I didn't really play it, so I didn't really make it my big surprise of the year, so I couldn't really speak towards whether I enjoyed it or not, since I didn't play it. And then, of course, for those fans out there that kind of wanted what was the name of that show? Firefly or whatever? There was an indie game called Rebel Galaxy that really encompassed the whole spirit of the whole Firefly TV show that I played, that I love playing. It's a lot of fun. Very, very good game. And then, of course, my one staple, as I tried to go through and play every MMO that I could. You know, I tried Neverwinter, and it was decent. I tried Elder Scrolls Online. It was all right. I tried Star Wars Knights of the Republic or whatever. It was okay. I forget what other MMO. I tried a couple other MMOs and nothing really captured me in this, and it's probably because the one MMO that I kind of played to death all year long was MechWarrior Online, and they have essentially captured me, just mainly because I love MechWarrior. And they finally started releasing mechs that I remember from the old MechWarrior games, and they've been releasing them at prices that I can afford, unlike some of the other mechs that they've been releasing on the games early on. So I've been going bonkers on that all year long, learning how to play it. It's an extremely deep game, extremely complicated when you start getting into, you know, upgrading your mechs, upgrading the weapon systems, and changing the loadouts and all this other kind of stuff. Just like in MechWarrior, it's very, very involved. And then, of course, playing it is pretty difficult as well. So, definitely skill-based. You have to learn, pretty big learning curve, but once you get into it, and once you finally figured out what your gameplay style is, of course, MechWarrior Online, I just love it. I'm a big mech guy anyways. If it's got mechs in it, I gotta try it.
Wow. Yeah, so, yeah. I'm actually interested in that Transformer game. I haven't really been into mech games for a really long time, because I haven't had anything to really, like, go gaga over, but I was watching the Transformer
Devastation.
I was watching that on the screen, and I'm like, you know what? I couldn't take my eyes off of it. I'm like, yo, I really want to play that game.
It's dope. It's a lot of fun. From the one thing that I will say about it that I've heard a lot of people say is that it's more of a rental than it is anything else, because it's kind of short, and Even though it's got all the voices and everything that you could ever dream of and everything, you know, once you play through it once, there's not really a whole lot more to do, you know.
Yeah.
But it's a lot of fun. It's your classic action game. They finally got the art style right, which is what all Transformers fans wanted. And, you know, like I said before, it's got all the right voice acting and stuff in it. So it's a lot of fun. I'll definitely say that. Lots of fun. It's hard.
Yeah. I just want something where, like, I want something with some challenge. I want my headphones to be overloaded with the I want to be able to feel like I'm in the game. I miss games that put me into it and make me feel like I'm a part of the game.
Right.
That's my problem.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And yeah, you'll have to wait a little while for all that VR stuff to really pop off on top of that, since we all know it's going to cost an arm and a leg to have all that going on. So we shall see whether that finally gets to a point that that will finally pull you into the right immersion level that you're looking for. But yeah, I can feel you. I can feel you. It's hard to find that game that, you know, once you start playing it, you're like, this is me. I'm there. I'm in there. You know, the sound, you know, like you said, with the earphones and everything, it just pulls you in, and you just don't want to jump back out. You know, for a while there, I would have said playing something like maybe Fallout or something like that would kind of do that. But I haven't put on the headphones since I've tried to play it. And I know every once in a while you'll hear something off in the distance and be like, oh, snap. and I'll say this. Fallout, the difficulty level of Fallout 4 is definitely harder than the difficulty level I found when I was first playing Fallout 3. And the reason why I say that is because all the raiders and the mutants and everything, they throw freaking grenades like they've got 200 of them. It's like every time you run into a group of raiders or something like that, they are constantly throwing grenades and stuff at you. And then one of the other things I recognize is that when you first run into super mutants, and you'll find this out, Jay, if you haven't run into them yet, make certain that you spot them from a distance, because a lot of times the super mutants, when they're outside, they either have missile launchers or they have mini nukes. And when they have, you know, the, what is it called, the Fat Man launcher or whatever, if you hear that sound where it goes, you better run. You had better that run.
To me, I ran into this small town.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't that big, maybe about 15, 20 houses.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, the stupid dog went barking. He's like, oh, you found something, right? And I went next to this beat up car and I heard it. It was like, dude, I turned around.
Kaboom!
Gone. Gone. And I didn't save for like maybe 45 minutes. Like,
yeah. It'll get you quick.
So that's.
Yeah. Well, they do that, and they actually have suiciders too. So if you hear a guy and you all of a sudden just hear something beeping and the beeping is getting closer, that means it's one of those super mutants and he's got a mini nuke with him and he's just running towards you and he will commit suicide and just destroy everything. So make sure you spot them from a distance. You know, if you're going to any kind of encampment or area or whatever.
I've been doing a lot of sneaking around.
Yeah.
I love it. The only thing that are getting me right now is like, if I'm out in the wild and I get jumped by a pack of scorpions or.
Oh, hell yeah, they tore me apart.
Oh man, the big ones, they get you.
Mm-hmm.
And the freaking bees, man, or like, something, you know?
Uh-huh.
Whacking, and then like half their energy go away, then they go crazy and they just like tear you up.
Yep.
That's kind of like my frustration now. But I know what you're saying. Like, I did real. I'm like, yo, is this shit really, really hard?
I know, right? It catches you off guard. It's a lot harder. All your enemies dodge a lot better.
Yes, they do.
Then they get Fallout 3. It's
on enemies that I've missed.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's pretty difficult. And it'll get a lot worse. Goodness, I'm just glad I haven't run into one of those death claws yet, or what is it called, you know, those big reptile things with the horns, yeah, and don't even remember what they're called, but they are so freaking hard. I ran into one in one town and I let like the raiders like take it down before I ran in there after it.
Yeah, there's like, I've been seeing online, there's like really good armor you can get too.
Yeah, you can get, I mean, the power armor you get, you just have to have the core. Right. You have to make certain you find the core. Yeah, that first little town that you go into, that has, you'll get the power armor there, because they give you like a minigun at the top of the When you save them. Yeah. And then you know, you can essentially use that and keep repairing that as you go through. But yeah, I can't wait to get into some more Fallout 4. I'm gonna do that later on tonight. But yes, ladies and gentlemen, 2015 is just about done. This has been a spectacular year for us here at Geek Swag. We had a lot of really great guests. We had a lot of really great interviews. We had a lot of great shows. You know, we did some pretty good shows this year, people. You know what I mean? Right. We've been doing this for what? About a year, a little bit, almost 2 years, right?
Yeah, something like that. Wow.
Yeah, it's been about 2 years. We're closing in on the whole, 60 episode mark. I'm guessing I want to say we'll hit the 100 mark by next year, maybe, I guess, or pretty close to it, I think. Okay. Yeah. But all of our guests, from Chris Willits from, you know, designnews.com, Angelina Montanez from techwelike.com, who else did we have this year? We had Harmonix at the beginning of the year. I forget his name. I have to look through the through our show notes, but I'd try to see if I can get him back on maybe and see how that whole thing is going. The whole VR chair, yeah, the whole VR chair guy that we had on at the beginning of the year, that was, I think it was. Yeah, yeah, I think a lot of people would be looking for something of that manner. Man, who else did we have? We had the author from Game Believes in You. That was a really great interview. We had a lot. We did a lot this year. It's really been a great year. I really, really thank you guys for hanging in there with me this year. We had Lauren from blackgirlnerds.com.
Mm-hmm.
That was a great show. Goodness. We had our E3 show, talking a lot about all the stuff that happened with E3. I don't know. I'd have to go back through the archives. Just so much. But as always, our time is done here, ladies and gentlemen. We thank you guys, as always, for being with us this entire year. We're hoping we can step it up a notch for this coming year, have a lot more videos, a lot more Let's Plays, a lot more group streaming sessions where we can hopefully get all three of us on a console or a PC game all together, have some Geek Swag playing sessions where, you know, we all can get in a chat room and play with a few people on whatever game we decide to play. We're going to try to organize more of those in the coming year, as well as try to see if we can maintain our interview swag and get some more great guests on the show. And then who knows, maybe we'll actually be able to get a little bit of studio time in to get some really, really professional looking interviews going. You never know. You never know what could happen this year. But again, another good year is to come. Great years in the past. And we really, really want to thank Ladies of the Round Table for having us here on the channel. Here's to another great year. Thank you, Makita, for a great year.
Oh, thank you, guys. Fantastic.
Thank you, Jason, for a fantastic year. And here's to a great one coming up.
That's an amen to that.
Yup, yup, yup. We love you guys. Thank you for tuning in. And definitely make sure you stay tuned, because some more great stuff is to come. We love you guys. And... Happy peace. New Happy New Year.
See you.